How you doing, MTBR? John Kennedy here, marketing manager for Diamondback Bikes. We're on day three of the indoor show, and we're taking a moment just to kind of go over some of the product today. Big push for us this year is the new addition to the line, which is the 2012 Sortie 2.9er line. There's four models to choose from, ranging from a Dior build all the way up to an XTR build. And what we did when in building this bike is really tried to focus on capturing the essence of what we love so much about the Sortie 26-inch version, which has been a great seller for us, and incorporated that technology into the 2.9-inch version as well. You know, we've got a tapered head tube here. We've got our legendary knuckle box suspension, which is, you know, throughout a good majority of the line, sans the downhill bike. Direct mount front derailleur, which takes some finagling to make that work with a 29-inch wheel. We went with a 142 by 12 millimeter rear through axle on this, which you'll see on a good majority of the knuckle box bikes this year. Not all of them, just because some of the lower ones, we want to keep a price point in a good position for people that have a little bit less budget to spend. Again, full XTR build, Dior all the way up to the XTR. Prices start at $2,600. Good stuff. All right, so not a 2012 model. I just want to be really clear about that. There's been a lot of interest. A lot of people have been inquiring about when this bike is going to be available. I just kind of want to set the record straight. The bike will be available when it is ready. We've got the entire Development Force 5 Pro Factory team working on with our engineers on this to really kind of flush out the best possible downhill race rig that we can. This is the second iteration of the DH prototype, and you know, some of the changes that we made are actually steepening up the head angle on this to about 64 degrees. It was a little slack in our first prototype, which is fine. That's how a production goes sometimes. Went to a internal routing for the rear derailleur. It's an option at this point. You'll see on the bike, we threw a lot of options in there, and what that does is it gives us the ability to flush out some of the things that we like or we don't like, to try different versions. You know, for instance, we've got an adjustable shock mount position on this, three different positions. That enables us to kind of slacken it out, raise, lower the BB, and find the best possible position for this bike. We're hoping that we can have something together in 2013. That's a possibility. But again, we've got the Development Force 5 team working on this closely with our engineers. And you know, hopefully you'll see more of this bike around up at Whistler, your local park, and ripping up local DH trails. Another thing that we're really excited about this year for 2012 is our frame-only offerings. This is actually the first year that Diamondback has offered a frame-only offering. We felt that really is something that our consumer wanted. We've heard that for a number of years, and so we've gone that. And you know, we went a little bit extra to give some of our consumers a little bit of a bonus when buying our frame. So you'll notice we've got the Mission Pro here as a frame offering. That's going to be a 6 and 6 inch bike, more of your all-mountain rig. We've got the Scapegoat, which will often be offered as a frame only. The Scapegoat is a 7 and 6 inch bike, more of your park kind of hucker bike. We've got the Dreamliner here, or the 4X slope style bike. Again, it's really generally meant for your 4-cross slope style crowd. And you know, one of the things that we want to do is give people the tools that they need right away to get the bike rolling. 142 by 12 rear through axles is new, relatively new to the industry. We know that there's not a lot of people out there with wheel sets in hand to build those up. And so we're going to give all of those people a free hub to go in with it so that you know, you can get started and you know, have a wheel set built up right away to get rolling. You'll also notice that seat posts are offered with all of the bikes. The Dreamliner includes a seat as well. And then the Mission Pro comes with a RockShox Reverb hydraulic post, which we thought is a nice bonus and you know, hopefully an incentive for people to want the frame. They also come with headsets are included, which is a zero stack tapered headset. So really kind of focusing on giving everybody what they're going to need to get that frame built and on the trail fast. All right, the 2012 Assault. Bike that everybody's really excited about, Billy Lewis's go-to steed. Not a lot of changes this year. We've done some top tube revisions, made it a little bit cleaner and sleeker. New graphics, which are a kind of a nod to Kelly and the Kiwis. And then we've got also, you know, it's a single-speed specific bike, really meant for kind of your street, park, you know, and dirt jumper. Two versions of this. We've got the Assault and the Assault 2, and this will also be offered as a frame only, so giving people a lot of options. 2012 Scapegoat. Probably one of my favorite bikes in the line for a number of reasons. Made a few changes to this bike this year. Went with a reinforced down tube on this guy, a 142 by 12 millimeter through axle in the rear. Suspension technology is going to stay the same. Knuckle box suspension lies low and tight within the frame, giving you a great cornering ability because of the low center of gravity on that thing. Went with a Kashima coated Fox 180 36 up front and a Kashima coated Fox DHX5 in the rear. It's spec'd out with Easton Havoc wheels, post, bar and stem, and then went with a full Shimano drivetrain on this thing with an XTR drivetrain and Shimano Saint brakes. This bike is ideal for your park shredders or guys really wanting to send it or hit some gravity lines. Again, one of my favorite bikes this year, and I think you'll love it too. 2012 Mission Pro. Refined this line a little bit. Last year we had four versions of this bike. We've kind of narrowed that down to two, which is the Mission and the Mission Pro. Here's the Mission Pro, as I said before, and this is really geared towards your all mountain riders, somebody that wants to climb up it as well and have a nice cush, burly descent. Six inches up front and 6 inches in the rear with a 36 up front and RP23 in the back. Spec'd really nicely with an Easton Havoc setup. You've got a SRAM drivetrain on this guy and then a race face carbon crank. This bike comes in at around 32 pounds, and for the all mountain crowd, I know we're all going this direction, but you can't forget the Reverb post. This is also going to be offered in our frame only of the Mission Pro, so it's kind of an added incentive to not only just get the frame, but get the post along with it. So great all mountain rig right there. 2012 Overdrive Series. Few refinements this year, but this bike has quite a story. The Overdrive was actually one of the first, if not the first, 2.9er to hit the market back in the 90s. Working closely with Panaracer to come up with a Panaracer smoke tire that was a 2.9er size. Took a little bit to catch on, as you know, but I think the 29er thing is here to stay, and we're pleased to offer four versions of this bike, starting at 550 and onward up to 1750 in the Overdrive Pro here. A little bit of a change this year in the look and the tubing of this. We've kind of refined it. Nice gloss highlights on a matte finish on all of the bikes. Again, there's four models to choose from, ranging from 550 to 1750. And if you're looking to get into the 2.9er market, this is probably a good place to start. If you want to learn more about any of the Knucklebox bikes or Diamondback bikes in general, you can go find us online at www.diamondback.com.